it was still all pretty scary.
Jackie Schnabel describing the moment she received that email with a link containing the personal information of thousands of students.
Found out that on Snapchat, some kids had obtained some screenshots or for the information from their parents, and were using Snapchat as a way to basically say, you know, I have your information, I have your parents' phone number, I have your address, I know where you live.
Schnabel says she wants to know that this will not happen again.
When you fill out these forms, usually at the beginning of the year, you're filling it out for, okay, my kid is bused. This is our address and this is where the nearest bus stop is.
Are you aware of what's private and what's public?
Probably not. Like many other parents, probably not.
So what is public and what is private?
Student information is generally considered private. Districts are able to establish policies around directory information, which would be certain pieces of a student's data that might be available to the public. And that could range from anywhere from a student's name to their address, phone number. It could even, for athletes, include height and weight.
Josh Collins with the Minnesota Department of Education says it's law for a district to inform parents each year on what information could be made public. He also says parents need to be given the opportunity to opt out of providing that information.
We don't have oversight or authority over data practices when it comes to districts.
Collins says these laws are set at a local level, and that's where the accountability needs to be. As for the link, it's been taken down, but some say the damage is already done.
Many people have it saved.
Within the past hour, I heard from a district spokesperson who says their policy regarding student privacy is on tonight's school agenda. I am told the district is working on updating their opt-out form and will post that on their website next week. Randy and Julie.
All right. Thank you, Zach.